I need your suggestions for RV air conditioner troubleshooting.
You're going to need to clean the coils, especially if you've been driving without a protective shell over the RV AC. After all those bugs hitting the windshield are hitting its air intakes too.
I do not even have coil cleaner at the house, much less in an RV where space is at a premium.
You can use the same stuff to clean house HVAC equipment to clean the RVAC coils, though you can use soapy water to clean them too, as long as you dry everything out.
I do not think that's the problem with the unit.
The filters have to be replaced too. And an RV air filter is more likely to get clogged from the car's smog than the one at your house.
I know I could get a replacement, but not out here.
You can use a wet dry shop vac to try to clean the air filters, since they are probably too big to get rinsed out in the RV sink.
What else could I do to try to fix it?
You could use a coil fin comb to straighten bent pins, but the one for your home unit may not fit the RV AC coils.
One for a window AC is more likely to fit.
You can try to clean the RV AC fan motor, especially if something may have nested in there while it was in the garage.
When they say the fan sits in a squirrel cage, I never thought it might be literal.
Even an RV should have WD-40, and you can spray that into the fan bearings, if it is having trouble turning. I'm not sure if it is enough for the fan oiling ports, though other lubricants might work.
That might not be enough to get me a cool breeze.
If the thing is still reluctant to turn after getting oil, you probably need to replace the fan. If the fan blows but the AC is still full of hot air, you have a refrigerant leak.
Or all the refrigerant is gone.
The hard part is getting the refrigerant recharged, because only licensed HVAC people can get a hold of it. Ask a car mechanic if he can recharge it, since he probably recharges car ACs.
I wonder if it is an AC capacitor problem.
It goes bad often enough in home ACs. Get a new capacitor for that specific AC model and you should be good to go.
Unless it is something else that went wrong.
You can get thermostats, switches and stuff online if not at the RV parts dealer. A compressor is usually so expensive to replace that you might as well get a new RV AC.
At least it would be in the tradition of changing out the gas cap.